Hey guys, and welcome back to episode 2 of the Iron Man series. I just want to start out by saying thank you so much for all of the support on the last video. It was really overwhelming reading all of your positive comments, so I'm super thankful for that. Anyways, let's get right back into the second episode. Today we are going to start out by crafting our daily air runes. This takes us up to 441 air runes, and that takes us up to 9 rune crafting. Now we are going to pick up where we left off in the last episode. We are currently working towards unlocking safecracking so that we can hit 90 thieving to unlock play on ports. So now I'm going to go to Tavoli and I'm going to pickpocket the merchants there until I hit 5 thieving. Okay, so we just did 5 thieving. It is just about time for Egg of Ixion cash, so I'm going to make my way over to Felidor to unlock the lodestone and then do the cash. I'll see you guys there. So we made our way over to the Rift, and now we are going to close the client, click on the settings button, and we are going to swap over to a French world. We are swapping over to a French world so that we can be there with less players, so there are less players to compete with, which should make it a lot easier to actually get our 100 points. But anyways, I will show you guys how many points I end up with right after this cache. So we are now in the cache, and I'm basically just going to camp the quest statue, going into the quest form every time it's off cooldown. And I'm not going to bother throwing in the memories in the rift, since I only get 1 point at 1 divination, which is basically nothing. Okay, that went really well. We surprisingly actually managed to cap our points at 100 in one single run, so that was sort of unexpected. And that takes us up to 17 divination. Look at that! We also managed to pick up a piece from the divination outfit. That is going to be super helpful in the future. We made our way back to the English worlds, and the next thing that we are going to be thieving are the cake stalls in Lumbridge. We don't have the Lumbridge lodestone and the Draenor lodestones, so I'm going to run over to Draenor, unlock the lodestone, and then end up in Lumbridge where I will be thieving the cakes. So we made our way over to Lumbridge, unlocked the lodestone, and I'm now going to thieve the cakes until I hit 15 thieving, so that I can unlock the pickpocket, the doors in the Thieves Guild. There we have it, 15 thieving coming up, and I'm now going to do the first quest in this account, being Buyers and Sellers, to unlock the first section of the Thieving Guild. So I'll see you guys when I finish that. Okay, so we just finished Buyers and Sellers. So now we have the doors unlocked, and I'm going to be picklocking the doors until I hit 30 thieving, which shouldn't take too long at all. We are just going to hop worlds every time we clear the northern doors, and I have a small tip for you guys. If you go under hop world, you can actually click the box right here. This makes it so that you don't have to click the confirmation button every time you hop a world, which speeds up the process a bit. Anyways, I will see you guys when I hit 30 thieving. There we have it, we just hit 30 thieving. This didn't take long at all, and now we are going to do the feud quest. To do the quest, however, we need a bit of GP, so we are going to make our way over to our beloved flag field again. So we just made 3 inventories of bowstrings and sold them, so that takes us up to 3000 gold, and we also got up to 2 crafting levels. So I'm just here doing the feud quests, and killing the mana fight could be a bit rough at our level since we are sort of low level, but the mob is actually really easy to safe spot, since you can just run into the camel pen as shown here, and then you can kill him over the fence. And here I am killing the bandit boss. He didn't have much HP at all, so I just used combustion on him, and then I walked him for a bit, and yeah, he went down pretty easily. Talking to Elimos Rain right here should be the finish point for the shoot for us, taking us up to 37 thieving and allowing us to do blackjacking. we also now have the requirements to do the next caper of the Thieving Guild questline from Tiny Acorns, so let us go ahead and do that. We finished from Tiny Acorns, so we can now train blackjacking in the Thieving Guild. And I just read on the wiki that if you talk to the instructor right here with a regular blackjack from the quest, then he will give us a rubber blackjack, allowing us to blackjack him when we hit 40 thieving. So we just hit 40 thieving, which means that we can now do blackjacking. It is extremely click intensive and it requires full attention, but it is also really fast experience. The way blackjacking here works is that you need to right click him to lure him, to get the instructor to get into the hallway right here. After that, you want to come up behind him and close the door, so that way he gets stuck and he can't move away from us. Now, every time we need to press lure, and then go through the chat box, and then we need to press knockout. If we are fast enough, we can actually loot him 3 times after we knock him out, so it is a lot of experience, but it is really click intensive and it requires pretty precise timing to actually get all 3 loots in the knockout.
2 hours later.
Oh my god, finally, we just hit 62 thieving. That will be our first requirement for a guild of our own. And I think that I will unlock Herblore now by doing the Druidic Ritual, which will also give us a few Herblore levels to start out with. So I'll see you guys in a second. Coming up here, that should be the Druidic Ritual completed. That takes us up to 3 Herblore and rewards us with a few Herblore supplies. Let us turn them into attack potions and see where that takes us. So we just finished turning our herbs into potions, and that takes us up to 7 Herblore, which is a nice start, but that doesn't take us anywhere close to 46 Herblore. In the last episode, I bought the Premier Club Gold Package, so that also gives us 151,000 loyalty points, so I think it's time to make it rain. So, just like that, that's 150k loyalty points spent, and we decided to pick up the first 3 tiers of Jack of Trades, meaning up to Supreme. I honestly think it's a waste to buy the Legendary tier, as it takes way longer than the Supreme version to complete, and the experience isn't even that much higher, so I just decided to stick with the Supreme tier. Other than that, we also picked up the first 2 tiers of the Ranged and Mage Acquisitions, and we will probably spend our future loyalty points on further upgrades of these, since they are pretty neat for medium tier people. But yeah guys, that is going to be it for this episode, but before you go, please feel free to follow me on my Twitch channel over on twitch.tv/watchstilo. I plan to do a stream sometime this week, so if you follow me there, then you'll get a notification when I go live. Other than that, I also made a Discord that you guys can join if you guys want to come and chat with me. And if that isn't your cup of tea, then I'm also in my friends chat. Finally, these videos take a huge amount of time to edit, so a like would be amazing. And if you guys haven't already, then be sure to subscribe to my channel for more Iron Man content in the future. But that is going to be it for me guys. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye bye.